Have you ever told yourself, "I'm just not a language person"? Have you spent months or even years wrestling with grammar apps and vocabulary lists only to find you can barely string a sentence together in a real conversation? You are not alone. For decades, we've been sold a lie about language learning, the myth that it's a rare gift, a language gene you're either born with or you're not, or that if you didn't learn as a child, the window of opportunity has slammed shut forever. This is fundamentally wrong. The failure isn't in your brain, it's in your method. The truth is, your brain is a language learning machine. Built by millennia of evolution to connect and communicate. But to activate its full potential, you can't rely on the outdated, inefficient methods taught in schools. You need a system grounded in the hard science of how our minds actually acquire and retain new information. In this video, we are not going to give you superficial hacks. We are going to give you the blueprint. These are the five fundamental, non-negotiable laws of language acquisition, derived from decades of research in neuroscience, linguistics, and cognitive psychology. If you follow them, fluency is not a possibility, it's an inevitability. Let's start by dismantling the single most destructive belief in language learning, the idea of innate talent. For years, the critical period hypothesis was cited as proof that the adult brain's wiring for language becomes fixed, making learning nearly impossible. But modern neuroscience has shown this to be a gross oversimplification. The key is a concept called neuroplasticity. Neuroplasticity is your brain's remarkable ability to reorganize itself by forming new neural connections throughout life. Every time you expose yourself to a new word or a grammatical pattern, you are physically rewiring your brain. While children may have an edge in acquiring a native-like accent due to phonetic flexibility, adult learners possess significant, often overlooked, advantages. We have superior abstract thinking, better developed learning strategies, and most importantly, a powerful, conscious motivation, the why behind our desire to learn. The evidence is clear. Studies on adult second language learners consistently show that while the path of learning might differ from that of a child, the destination of high proficiency is absolutely attainable. The talent we see in successful polyglots is not a magical gift. It is the consistent application of a superior method. So the first and most critical action is a mental one. You must consciously reject the limiting belief that you are bad at languages. Your brain is perfectly capable. Your past failures were failures of strategy, not of intellect. From this moment on, you operate under the assumption that with the right system, you will succeed. This mindset shift is the foundation upon which everything else is built. How does a baby learn its first language? Not with flashcards or grammar drills. A baby learns through thousands of hours of immersion in what linguist Stephen Krashen famously termed comprehensible input. Comprehensible input is language that you understand, even if you don't know every single word. It's content that is just slightly above your current level, what Krashen called I+1. This is the engine of language acquisition. Why? Because our brains are pattern recognition machines, not data processors. When you focus on understanding the message of what you're hearing or reading, your brain subconsciously absorbs vocabulary, grammar, and sentence structure without the tedious effort of rote memorization. Trying to learn a language by studying grammar. Rules first is like trying to learn how to swim by reading a book on fluid dynamics. You need to get in the water. The scientific evidence for this is overwhelming. Learners in immersion environments who are constantly exposed to meaningful, context-rich language consistently outperform those in traditional classrooms focused on explicit grammar instruction. The action here is to re-engineer your environment. Your goal is to accumulate hundreds, then thousands, of hours of comprehensible input. This doesn't have to be a chore. Integrate the language into things you already love. Do you like watching crime dramas? Find one on Netflix and watch it in your target language with target language subtitles. Do you listen to podcasts on your commute? Find one for native speakers on a topic you find fascinating. Listen to music, read news articles, follow social media influencers who post in that language. The key is that the content must be compelling enough to hold your attention. You should be so focused on the story or the information that you almost forget you're learning. This is how you build a powerful, intuitive sense of the language, just like a native speaker. Input alone is not enough. To truly own a piece of information, you must actively retrieve it from your memory. This is the principle of active recall, and it is the mortal enemy of passive learning. Most of us study by rereading notes or rewatching lectures. This is a highly inefficient method because it creates what psychologists call the illusion of fluency. You recognize the material, so you think you know it. But recognition is not the same as recall. Active recall forces your brain to work, to pull information out of storage. This effort is what strengthens the neural pathways, making the memory stronger and more durable. The most powerful system for implementing active recall is spaced repetition. In the 19th century, psychologist Hermann Ebbinghaus discovered the forgetting curve, which shows that we forget information exponentially over time. A spaced repetition system, or SRS, combats this by scheduling reviews at the precise moment you are about to forget. The action is to stop being a passive consumer and become an active learner. Use an SRS application, like Anki. This is non-negotiable for efficient vocabulary acquisition. But don't just create flashcards with a single word on each side. Create sentence cards. Put a full sentence with a target word on one side and the translation or definition on the other. This way, you're learning words in context, which is exponentially more effective. Every day, spend 15 to 20 minutes clearing your SRS queue. This small, consistent effort will allow you to build and permanently retain a massive vocabulary with far less time and frustration than traditional methods. You are not just studying, you are actively building the architecture of your new language inside your mind. Not all words are created equal. In any language, a tiny fraction of the vocabulary accounts for the vast majority of daily communication. This is the Pareto principle, or the 80-20 rule, applied to language. For example, in English, the 3,000 most common words account for over 90% of most texts. In Spanish, the top 1,000 words make up nearly 88% of spoken language. Many beginners make the critical mistake of trying to learn everything at once, obscure vocabulary, complex grammar tenses, and quickly become overwhelmed. This is inefficient and demotivating. The strategic learner understands that the fastest path to conversational fluency is to relentlessly focus on what matters most. The evidence for this is in the data itself. Linguists create frequency lists that rank words by how often they are used. By mastering the first 1,000 to 2,000 words on that list, you are not learning just 1,000 words. You are unlocking the ability to understand and express the vast majority of everyday ideas. This gives you a massive return on your time investment and builds the momentum you need to stick with it. Your action is to be ruthless in your prioritization. Find a frequency list for your target language. Make these words the core of your initial SRS efforts. Focus on the most common verbs, nouns, and connectors. Learn the core grammatical structures that allow you to use these words effectively. Don't get sidetracked by obscure vocabulary for animals at the zoo or complex conditional tenses until you have a rock-solid foundation in the high-frequency essentials. Get conversational first, then achieve perfection later. This is the law that separates the perpetual student from the confident speaker. You can spend a decade mastering the first four laws, accumulating a massive vocabulary and a perfect understanding of grammar, but if you do not produce the language, you will never be fluent. Many learners fall into the trap of silent perfectionism, waiting for the day they feel ready to speak. That day will never come. Speaking is not the final exam of language learning. It is a core part of the training process itself. Linguist Merrill Swain's output hypothesis suggests that the very act of trying to speak or write forces our brains to notice the gaps in our knowledge. When you try to say something and realize you're missing a word or a grammatical structure, your brain flags it. The next time you encounter that structure through input, you are primed to notice and acquire it. Mistakes are not failures. They are data. They are crucial signposts showing you exactly what you need to work on. The evidence is seen in every fluent, non-native speaker. They did not become fluent by avoiding errors. They became fluent by making thousands of them and learning from each one. The action is simple, but not easy. Speak before you feel ready. Start on day one. If you have no one to talk to yourself. Narrate your day. Describe the objects in your room. This is called self-talk, and it's a powerful way to activate the language in your brain without pressure. Then, as soon as you can, find a language partner on a platform like Italki or Tandem. Your first conversations will be clumsy. They will be filled with pauses and mistakes. This is normal. Embrace the discomfort. The goal of your early conversations is not perfect communication. It is simply the act of trying. Fearless output is the fire that forges all your theoretical knowledge into real, practical, and usable skill. So, there you have it, the five scientific laws of language learning. First, you change your mind, understanding that your brain is built to learn. Second, you immerse yourself in comprehensible input, absorbing the language naturally. Third, you build a permanent memory of that language using active recall and spaced repetition. Fourth, you focus strategically on the most common words and structures to get conversational fast. And fifth, you practice fearless output, speaking before you feel ready, and turning mistakes into lessons. Notice what these laws create: a powerful, self-reinforcing cycle. Input gives you the material, active recall solidifies it, strategic priority makes it manageable, and output puts it to the test, revealing your weaknesses and guiding your future learning. This is not a collection of tips, it is a system. It's how you stop being a student of a language and start becoming a user of it. The journey to fluency is not a mysterious art, it is an engineering problem. And now, you have the blueprint. The work is still required, but it is smart work, not just hard work. You now know exactly what to do. Now, I want to hear from you. We've talked about the system, but motivation is the fuel. In the comments below, tell us two things. What is the number one language you want to master? And what is your biggest why for learning it? Sharing your goal is the first step to achieving it. If this guide provided you with a clear path forward, show your support by hitting the like button and subscribe to the Brainline for more no BS wisdom to master your mind and your life. Now go and start building your multilingual brain.